The Tasmanian devil has another name, the marsupial devil. It represents the family of predatory marsupials, as well as the genus marsupial devils, and it is the only representative of this genus. Naturally, many people wonder why this animal has such a frightening name. The colonists, who arrived in Tasmania from Europe, nicknamed the animal so. They were greatly frightened by the sounds made by this animal, so they called the mammal the Tasmanian devil. It is likely that they were right, as the character of the behavior corresponds to the name of the animal. The character of the behavior of the Tasmanian devil cannot be called peaceful, although what can be expected from a predator? Its large mouth with sharp fangs, as well as its practically black woolly coat, only reinforce the opinion of man. In Latin, the name of the animal translates as lover of flesh. A more thorough study with genetic tests showed that the closest relatives of this predator are marsupial martens, quolls, as well as marsupial wolves, Tylosini, which became extinct. This species was first officially described scientifically in the early 19th century, and in 1841 this species received its scientific name and also qualified as the only mammal that represents the marsupial carnivores that inhabit the expanses of the Australian continent. Interesting point. The Tasmanian devil is considered the largest marsupial predator living on our planet. The size of this Australian predator is comparable to the size of an average dog. The body length of adults reaches 50 to 80 centimeters, with body weight ranging from 10 to 12 kilograms. The Tasmanian devil bears some outward resemblances to a dog, as well as to a small bear, with the cut of the eyes as well as the shape of the snout indicating a resemblance to a koala. In any case, the appearance of the animal in no way indicates a very bad character of this animal. On the contrary, the appearance indicates a peaceful and gentle creature of nature. Males, in comparison with females, are larger in size. In addition, the female can be distinguished by the presence of a skin fold in the form of a pouch that opens backwards. This pouch conceals four nipples. This predator is characterized by a rather dense and stocky build. At first glance, the Tasmanian devil is a clumsy animal, but in fact it is a strong, agile, and muscular animal. It has short limbs, with the front limb slightly longer than the hind limbs, which is not characteristic of marsupial mammals. It has five toes each on its forelegs, one of which is a little farther apart from the others in order to securely hold its prey. The hind limbs lack the first toe. The fingers are armed with sufficiently strong and sharp claws that allow the predator to simply tear through flesh. The head is disproportionate, as it looks quite large compared to the size of the whole body. The muzzle is slightly blunted, and the eyes are black. The ears of the beast are neat and rounded, and they stand out because they are pink in color. The muzzle stands out because it has long and expressive vibrissae, so we can safely say that the Tasmanian devil is an excellent hunter. The coat is short and almost black, although white oblong spots can be seen in the chest area and above the tail. There may also be an arrangement of white flecks on the flanks. Interesting to know. The physical condition of this predator can be judged by its tail. If the animal is well-fed and absolutely healthy, then its tail is also well-fed and covered with hair, as the tail serves as a kind of storage of fat reserves. This predator has quite powerful and large jaws, which indicate the strength of this animal. The predator has only one bite and the victim falls down dead, because due to its powerful jaws, the predator easily bites into the skull of any victim. In addition, the mouth is armed with native teeth, which easily grind any bone. From the name of this animal, it is not difficult to understand where this predator lives. This predator is found exclusively on the island of Tasmania and is endemic to this island territory. In other words, apart from this island, the Tasmanian devil is found nowhere else. A few centuries ago, the Tasmanian devil inhabited the Australian continent, but a number of anthropogenic factors had a negative impact on the vital activity of these animals, and they disappeared from the territory of Australia. First of all, the numbers of these animals were affected by wild dingo dogs, which began to actively hunt the Tasmanian devil as soon as they appeared on the Australian continent. It should also be noted the efforts of man, who ruthlessly began to exterminate these predators, as they made constant raids on chicken coops, as well as stealing lambs. As a result, the Tasmanian devil disappeared from Australia. On the island of Tasmania, the marsupial devil was not completely exterminated, but a law was passed which prohibited any hunting activities with respect to this animal. Nowadays, the Tasmanian devil inhabits the north, west, and central part of the island and tries to stay away from humans. These predators are quite voracious and greedy for food. At one time, they can eat a percentage of food that is about 15% of their own weight. If the animal is very hungry, it is able to swallow almost 40% of the food. The Tasmanian devil has a fail-safe method of hunting. It easily immobilizes its prey through a powerful bite that hits either the skull or the spine. Although these predators are not of impressive size, they can attack even quite large animals, but mostly weakened or sick ones. They often stalk herds of cows and sheep, and their excellent eyesight and keen sense of smell make it easy for them to find their prey. They find carrion very quickly, as it decomposes, and this smell is carried for many kilometers. Sometimes there may be several marsupial worms near a large carcass of a dead animal. They may have bloody fights over food, and they make loud, heartbreaking screams. As a result of such a feast, almost nothing is left of the animal, as the predators eat everything, including the bones. Important fact: Tasmanian devils hardly pay attention to what they eat, especially if they are very hungry. Along with flesh, they eat harnesses, pieces of cloth, plastic tags, collars, etc. The diet of Tasmanian devils is very varied, so their diet also includes plant food, in the form of fruits and root systems of various plants, as well as various fruits. They take food from other species of predatory animals, as well as eating the remains of food of larger predators. When there are any problems with sustenance, the nutrient stores located in the tail part of the animal come to the rescue. An important point: if they have to starve for a long time, they may attack their weaker brethren. Tasmanian devils prefer to live alone, and they are not tied to any one territory, which is not characteristic of many other predators. They do not quarrel for territories, except when dividing some large prey or for the right to impregnate a female. Activity of these predators peaks in the dark hours, and during the day they prefer to rest in their refuges located in caves, tree hollows, burrows, or dense vegetation. As a rule, there are several such shelters, but in the end they go to their future offspring. Besides the fact that Tasmanian devils have excellent hearing, sight, and smell, they feel quite well in water, but do not get into it without an absolute necessity. The youngsters are able to climb tall trees, which the older generation is not able to do. This fact helps the young to survive, especially in times of hunger, when the adults do not mind eating their younger counterparts. They are fairly clean animals, which sit and lick themselves for hours. This fact helps the animal to hunt potential prey, as the body of the predator is deprived of foreign odors in the grooming process. To wash or take water procedures, the critters fold their limbs into a bucket shape to scoop up water and then pour it over themselves. These predators are especially aggressive when threatened in any way, as well as when they attack themselves. Their behavior is brigandish and unbridled, and their vocalizations will make anyone who hears these heart-rending voices shudder. It should be noted that they are capable of making various sounds, but in their own special manner. Important to know: experts, as a result of the study of the life activity of these predators, found that they can emit up to 24 different sounds. Naturally, this set of sounds helps them to communicate with each other. These predators are quite aggressive and can easily fend for themselves. This is why Tasmanian devils do not have many enemies in their natural environment. As a rule, the birds of prey prey on the young, and adults are not to their liking. When foxes were introduced to Tasmania, they immediately became food competitors for Tasmanian devils as well as their natural enemies. To avoid having such a natural enemy as dingo dogs, Tasmanian devils appeared in places where wild dingo dogs do not feel comfortable. Though seemingly clumsy at first glance, this predator becomes strong, agile, and brave in moments of danger. He is able to move at a speed of up to 13 kilometers per hour, and has another effective way of protection: he secretes a stinky secretion, which is several times stinkier than that of skunks. Tasmanian devils sometimes act as their own natural enemies, as they can attack their fellow, weaker ones. The marsupials suffer from an incurable disease that occurs every 77 years. This disease is called a facial tumor. As a result of the epidemic, quite a number of members of this family die. Specialists are still unable to determine why this happens. Naturally, humans are also the natural enemy of the Tasmanian devils, the more so that thanks to humans, this species almost disappeared from the face of the earth. Nowadays, Tasmanian devils are heavily guarded, so the number of these marsupials has slightly increased and remains stable. As mentioned earlier, a few centuries ago these animals inhabited the vastness of the Australian continent. Nowadays this animal can be found only on the island of Tasmania, but even there the number of animals was catastrophically decreased because of human actions. Because of this, in 1941, the Australian authorities introduced a strict ban on hunting. Because of outbreaks of epidemics, the cause of which scientists have not yet figured out, in 1995 the number of these animals declined by almost 80%. The last outbreak was in 1950. What's interesting? The female gives birth to several dozens of cubs, but she has only two pairs of nipples. It is easy to assume that only a small proportion of the offspring survive, and the rest of the babies are eaten by the female herself. Despite the existing prohibitions, the number of Tasmanian devils is not at all high at the moment. Nevertheless, one must give credit to these measures, which allowed at least to stabilize the situation, which is a small consolation. If previously the species was on the verge of extinction, nowadays they want to give this species the status of a vulnerable species. This issue has not yet been resolved, but another fact is obvious: these animals require protection, so the task of all people is not to interfere, at least in the activities of the Tasmanian devil. Important fact: the Tasmanian devil has the most powerful bite, compared to other animal species, because its weight, in relation to its bite force, is considered to be the smallest. Although the number of Tasmanian devils is not large, it has been at a stable level for several years. This fact indicates that measures to strictly prohibit hunting, as well as the export of the animal, have had a positive effect. Man destroyed these animals in large numbers as the Tasmanian devils destroyed livestock. After tasting the meat of this predator, man began to destroy it for meat. As a result of such actions, the number of this predator decreased so much that it disappeared from the territory of Australia altogether. Nowadays, hunting of this animal is forbidden, as well as its export from the island. Only a terrible disease remains, for which scientists have not yet found a cure. It is a form of cancer, which has reduced the population of the Tasmanian devil by almost 50% in a decade and a half. Tasmanian devils are listed in the International Red Book and have endangered species status. Experts estimate that in 2006 there were about 80,000 individuals on the island, while in the 1990s the number of individuals was about 140,000. This is mainly due to this serious disease, as people cannot find a cure for it. We can only hope that humans will still find the cause of this disease, as well as ways to combat it. Tasmanian devils are not only unique animals, but also amazing. In addition, they are still being studied by specialists, as well as being of interest to the common man. This animal can be safely called a symbol of the Australian continent. Each animal, regardless of its behavior, occupies its own niche, ensuring the balance of our planet's ecosystem. The same can be said about Tasmanian devils, despite the fact that they are by no means peaceful, including in relation to humans. These predators are involved in the very important process of restricting the activities of many animal pests harmful to humans, as well as living creatures that can harm human health. This is evidenced by the fact that they feed on various insects, snakes, rodents, as well as rats. Man sometimes does not think about his actions, so he brought atypical animals to this continent, which increased the number of natural enemies. As a consequence, the natural balance was disrupted. As a result, native animals, including predators, began to suffer. Man, in turn, decided that the Tasmanian devils had no place in the vastness of Australia simply because they hunted domestic animals, as they needed to feed. With the advent of man, the diet of predators became less varied as man became a food competitor. Settlers from Europe, after their arrival on the Australian continent, caused enormous damage to wildlife. Nowadays, the Australian government is trying to save the situation, although measures are not enough. In addition, the population of this predator depends on a deadly disease for which no cure has yet been found. In other words, scientists have a lot of work to do to keep these unique animals from disappearing from the face of the earth.